Welcome to a new stream. My name is Ray, and today is a little bit of a special day here. I'm releasing my new project, which is a custom map pack for practicing fights in StarCraft. So this is just for the YouTube video. I will do it a bit later once there are enough people on the stream. So if you're watching the YouTube video right now, you'll probably find the timestamp in the video description to see the actual release. Okay, and until then, we will just go ahead and play some games. Okay, here we have our StarCraft, and let's see if the matchmaker is actually working now. So my, here it is already. So my MMR is super low, incredibly low, and I really have to do a bit more here. Did you get your points? What do you mean, did you get your points? From the times where they did not show up? No, I don't think so. You don't get points for that. You only get points if the game actually started. If the game tries to start and shows the players already and then just cancels it, then you don't get points. After the game's finished, I think I did. I hope. Maybe that's why my MMR is so low. I didn't even check that, to be honest. But I really feel like I had a big losing streak towards the end, so I'm not mad. I probably deserve it. So it's kinda laggy right now. Okay, not perfect, but it's better. Hello, China White. If a game was left undecided, you can check in match history to see. I will check the match history. But yeah, I just assume everything was fine. I like everything registered. Man, this is still laggy. I used to know who this Artanis is. Yeah, I really feel like I know the name as well, but I can't recall what's up with him. But he was almost 2k, so he's definitely not a bad player. Hi Lampshade, thanks for tuning in, man. I should scout at one point, I think. Should be a good idea. Good skill to have. Toa have. In StarCraft. Wait, what? What am I doing? Why am I scouting middle? This makes no sense. You You can see I'm already in a good shape right now. Oh, he goes out immediately. That's interesting. He's probably two gating me, and I should just die. Oh, he says fast expanding. Oh, Jesus. So this is my go-to reaction. I just make my own Nexus, except that my Nexus is slightly later. But I don't have to invest minerals into cannons, you know? That's the difference. So that way I balance out the fact that my Nexus is later again. You can do so much with only 4 goons. I barely lose anything, but I'm killing 2 cannons. Thank you. Okay. 5 gates. That's a lot. Okay, he's coming. And that's an easy fight. Okay, I really need to start making Templars here.
You have not enough minerals awaiting instructions. My life for Aya. She is commencing. Input command commencing. Make use of her.
I thought I made the cannon there. Man, this Reaver really did so much damage. Ah.
Steal thy being.
Wow. Oh, his harassment is strong. But my probe count is still not super bad. It's still possible to play this. If he doesn't have a fourth base, that is. He's still not mining here, what? How's he not mining forever?
You've not enough minerals.
Okay, there's really no base.
Fire.
just be gas, not enough minerals. Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Okay, there is a base. That was a good drop. I think also my army is not too bad now. Where is he?
Your warriors have engaged the enemy. My life for ire. Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Wow, he's so defensive. Under attack.
are under attack. Steve Dive B, I long for combat.
Ah, maybe not the best position.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Ah, damn it. So what is this guy doing, really? He's expanding to this position. What are his upgrades? 313. And okay, I need some more time. I only have 2-1. Where's this city now? It was here just a moment ago. Oh, where is it? Haha! Such a joke. Oh man, now he's attacking it again, and I can't kill his base. Just need some zealots, holy shit.
We are under attack.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy. I long for combat.
That's incredible. That is incredible that I can't break this expansion. Wow. It's crazy. These cannons top and the top there are winning the game. Okay, this is it. Pretty much my last army now. I don't need two Nexi. I can't support that. Oh my god.
warriors have engaged the enemy. Your command. Galarson. Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Have I won? Recall into my main. What a game, man. I was not prepared for this. Can't believe that the first game of the day is the most incredible game I've ever played. Wow, guys. Wow. What a game.
Focus. And ride a shade icon.
Oh my god, here's a big army! Wow! Wow! I guess he gets it up. I can't believe this game, guys. Where's the DT now? Oh my god, guys, what can I do? Are we now macroing to maxed out armies again? With both people taking a natural here? Both player taking main and natural, I mean? Oh, I have a lot of probes here. Oh, that's nice. That's nice. I can't believe we have a normal game again. strong, 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 strong. Oh man, this game. Wow! Oh, I don't have a Templar archive, oh no!
Engaged the enemy.
Oh, really?
Instructions for vengeance.
What a crazy game. I can't believe this game. We are almost an hour into this game. I just wanted a quick warm-up game before releasing my project. Did he on the way?
For vengeance, Mitora commencing. Initiated. Chance complete. Commencing. Loktai.
Thank you.
Awaiting instructions. Waiting focus. Transmit. Make yourself known. We hear you.
Got him! Yes! Feedback the Arbiter. Nice. MC not researched. Where is it?
majesty must feed. My life for ire.
Got him. That's it! That's it!
Thank you.
Wow, I'm not maxed on upgrades. No, 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 we are not attacking that. Oh my god! Oh my god! Over 1 hour! 1 hour 3 minutes! PvP! Oh god! Shit! What a game! Oh man! Crazy. I just want to see the very end, how much he had left. He did mine from the main position in the top left earlier, so I guess it was mined out. Wow. Over 1 hour PvP. That's rare, guys. That's really rare. Oh, this was a nice fight. This fight. Look, we are both maxed, okay? Both maxed out. Pretty much both same resources, same work account almost, both maxed out. Everything is the same, basically, right? Oh, and then look at these dorms. Oh, this fight was so good. This fight was so insane. Look at this. Oh, so nice. Look, he lost 40 supply just from the storms. Without the fight even, without him even attacking me, without really the armies clashing into each other, he already lost 40 supply just from the storms. And here I get another one as well. Ah, that was also nice. Yeah, 50 supply down. Just from the storms, basically. This was nice defense. Yeah, now I guess he's down. He's down. He could not attack me. I have an army coming here. I have this army. I can hold this. I can hold this this high ground. He cannot... like kill this base before my army arrives. Okay, and now this is last fight, I guess. Not the best fight for me. A lot of goons are attacking the Nexus or the cannons there. But I had enough storms. Okay, now he GG's. So let's take a look. He has 2 mineral blocks left here. I don't know why he's not mining, but okay, that's only 18 minerals. Yeah, he has nothing left. This base, that I killed this base, was important. And I still have 2k. So I want you guys to appreciate that, okay? So when I go out of this game, you can see I still have the resources to basically max out, right? I almost can max out. Not quite, but like 170, right? And he is at 67, okay? Remember that. And now look at the resources. He... Oh, let's look at this better. I mined like 6k less resources. So, I have 100 more supply in the end, if I spend my minerals. But I mined 6k less. So, over the whole span of the game, I was over 6k, 6k plus 100 supply, more effective when trading. 6k more effective trades. Think about that. That's crazy. And yes, he put a lot of cannons, like he invested in a lot of stuff that didn't help him win the game, right? I used my resources so much better. I basically used 6k plus the 2k I had in the bank in the end, so 8k. 8k minerals I did not use, but still come out ahead. Wow. 8k. That's 80 zealots, guys. 80 zealots. Over the whole span of the game, I killed 80 more zealots than he did. That's how you can think about it. Okay. Oh, what a game, man. Okay, let's take a look at some of the chat here. The engagements were always a lot better for Ray. Yes, positioning is key. Positioning is key in PvP. Zuba in the chat. Thanks. Ray, questions. Can you talk about upgrades in PvP? When you get forged, double forge, if it's super critical, your thoughts in general? Okay, so my thoughts in general about upgrades PvP. They are very good. I think they are very strong. You don't need to go like double forge on two bases. That's not really useful because you're spending a lot of resources and you could still die to like a Reaver push or whatever. Or you could die when he has Storm a bit earlier than you have. I think Storm is a key upgrade in this matchup. Storm is the best thing you could get. But I think after you get Storm, you should definitely get double upgrades, double forge, in my opinion. Once you have like three bases secured, you have Storm. So once you are in this position that you are ready to go into the late game, you definitely, that's the latest point where you should get double forge, in my opinion, because upgrades are super important, but you don't want to get the double forge and invest in a lot of gas too early before your Storm on two bases, because that delays your Storm and your opponent could get a Storm earlier and crush you in a fight, Storm against no Storm. So definitely get double forge upgrades after Storm and maybe after securing third base. And before that, I always get one forge and upgrade upgrade from one forge when I get my zealot speed. So like usually Citadel and forge are, I usually get them at the same time, and research speed and plus one at the same time. And then, as I said, I get the double forge after Storm, after third base. Okay, so that's my opinion about that, my general thoughts. What else do we have? After Storm, get High Temple Energy. I saw that comment about High Temple Energy. Yes, I think it's a good upgrade, but I think you overestimate a bit. I read it somewhere above in the chat, like High Templar Energy upgrade is the most important upgrade for Protoss or so. Or I don't agree. Let's say you have six High Templars in your army without the upgrade, okay? Six High Templars. Let's make it easy, they all have max energy, okay? So, 6 High Templars have 12 Storms. Okay, remember that. 12 Storms. Here, actually, you know what? Let's put this one in here, okay? Read here. So, let's say you have 6 High Templars with other energy. That means 12 Storms, right? So, what can you accomplish with the upgrade? You could only have 4 High Templars with energy upgrade and still have 12 Storms, because with energy upgrade they have 3, right? Okay. So that means you have 2 more High Templars, 1 Archon. Okay? That's what you can get with energy upgrade in this scenario. So there is always a hard limit, in my opinion, about how many storms you want to have in a fight. It doesn't, like, it's no benefit to have 25 storms in a fight, right? You will not be able to cast them all. So there is a limit on the number of storms you should have in a fight. And let's say that limit is 12. I think 12 is a good number. Usually you cannot really do more than 12 good storms in a fight. That's usually not possible, and the rest of the Templars should be Archons anyways. So this is, in my opinion, is the best case scenario already for the upgrade. And that best case scenario for the upgrade gives you 1 more Archon. Yeah, I don't think I need to add more. I don't really agree that it's super important. That is for the late game. Now let's check another scenario. I know LML, so this is the late game maxed out army scenario, okay? Now let's add another scenario. The you just got storm scenario, okay? Actually no, never mind. I will just talk about it. I'm not writing anything. So, the other scenario is, there are 3 scenarios. The one I just explained, not really useful to get the upgrade. Second scenario, you are on 2 bases, you just got the High Templars, and you have maybe only 2 High Templars. Yeah, okay, you have 6 Storms compared to 4. But how often does it happen that you have 2 High Templars or 3, and they can get to 250 upgrades before you have the gas to invest in more Templars? So this is only this timing window where you are maxing out that you have, yeah, maybe 1 more storm per Templar. So when you have 5 Templars, maybe you have 5 more storms before they max out on energy, because with the energy upgrade your High Templars spawn with more energy. But it's only like 12 more energy, so this timing window is just like 12 energy seconds. I don't know how many seconds you need to recharge 12 energy, but you get what I mean. It's not a big deal, in my opinion. It's really not a big deal. And now let's come to the third scenario. You're almost dying, you're trying to survive. Your enemy is pushing you. You are barely defending. Your High Templars spawn out of the gateways. With the energy upgrade, they have the storm almost immediately after spawning, like a few seconds after spawning, and you maybe survive. If you don't have the energy upgrade, they take a little bit longer, and maybe you're already dead before they have the energy. Okay, that's the third scenario. Again, I don't think it's super common, this scenario, because if you have the energy upgrade already, how often does it happen that like 2 or 3 High Templars spawning out of your gateways can barely make the difference to survive? I don't think it's that common. So. Okay, so that's my opinion. What do you have to say? Every unit you can kill can snowball the game in your favor. So having more storms because of the upgrade is huge. Well, that's my point. I don't think you have more storms. Right? Please explain to me how you get more storms. There is a hard limit on how many storms you can have in an army or how many you can really use in a big fight. There is a hard limit. More storms is not useful. If you have 6 High Templars, you have 12 storms without the upgrade. If you have the upgrade, you have 18 storms. Those 6 additional storms in a maxed out fight doesn't really help you because you're already busy enough to cast 12 storms and the fight is over by then. You can't cast 6 more good storms. So I'm really not seeing how you get more storms. How are more storms useful in a fight? Because a lot of times you won't have 6 High Templar. In mid game, the energy upgrade gives you a few extra storms, I'm sure. Well, provides any example. I'm happy to hear it, but I don't think it's realistic. I think it's very rare scenarios where you actually benefit from it. When he recalled you stormed his army on the high ground a bunch. Yeah, that is like one of these super rare scenarios where it would actually matter. Sure, yes. In that case, 100% in this game, the energy upgrade, 100% useful. No contest, no discussion there, okay? I'm just talking about the most common type of game. I don't think there are so many situations where you can actually get a big use of out of the energy upgrade. Well, more storms, more GG is just not true in my opinion. Like, there is really a hard limit on how much storms are useful in an army. If you have 25 High Templars and you have 50 storms, your fight will not go better compared to 10 Templars with 20 storms. You know? There's no usefulness in having too many storms. Yeah, it's worse to get mind control of his ARPs. I was just struggling on resources, but I should get it, yeah. You're remaking High Templars a whole game long. And every time you remake, you get to. Yeah. But most of the time, I have too many High Templars, anyways, in this late game, in this extreme late game, and I morph them to Archons because 25 storms in a fight are not useful, anyways. Like, I have enough storms. The moment I decide I have enough storms and merge them to Archons, in that moment, that 12.5 energy per Templar doesn't matter anymore, you know? Dark Archons start with feedback. Yeah, I think feedback. Yes, for feedback, you don't have to upgrade, and I think feedback is already very good against Arbiters, so that's why. The mind control was not like a super big upgrade to get. Oh, Anonymous, subscribing. Thank you. Okay, so. But you don't never lose your High Templar. You do not morph to Ar. Wait, what? But you never lose your High Templar that you do not morph to Archons. In a big fight, you usually lose High Templars if you're losing the fight, and if you're winning the fight, then you're keeping like half of them, maybe. Sometimes some get stormed, sometimes you lose half, sometimes you keep all. Who knows? You know? And in that case, again, I don't see the benefit. I don't see the big benefit. There's always a small benefit, don't get me wrong. But I don't see a big benefit, you know? If you have. Let's say after a big fight, you have 4 High Templars remaining after the fight, okay? They have 0 energy, you casted all your storms. Yeah, they get energy at the same rate than a Templar with upgrade. It doesn't matter, you regain the storms. You regain the storms the same rate, at the same rate. Anyways, I think yeah, I got my points across, I think, and We talked a lot already about this. So I actually want to change topics now. So after this over one hour PvP, I now want to finally tell you what project I'm working on, okay? So the title of my stream, everyone watching right now, check the title of this stream on Twitch. Check it out. And this is what the stream should be about. I just wanted to play a quick game and it ended up being an over 1 hour PvP. Okay, so let me drink. Okay, so I was working on, you know, I'm coaching sometimes, and when I coach people, first of all, when they are very low ranked, I teach them the basics, pro production, unit production, don't get supply blocked, etc. But at some point, if I'm coaching people at a certain level, very often the problem is big fights. Army positioning is super important at the higher level. Like, one of the most important parts after macro is army positioning and real good engagement, especially in matchups like PvT. It's so crucial to flank the Terran army, you know? And when I say that to the people that I coach, then they go like, yeah, okay, thanks. I tried to get into the ladder game, and maybe in one third of the games I have that race that I want to practice against, and maybe in half of those games I actually get to this situation, to the big fight that I want to practice. That's a lot of time you need to actually practice that. So I created a custom map concept to do this practice in a few seconds, okay? So I now released this, and I will show you. I have a custom map. I'm going into StarCraft now. We go into this. I'm calling it Race Battle Simulator. Okay? Race Battle Simulator. You can see all the maps you want. All the maps you want. You can practice any fight, any situation on any popular map. So I invite you guys to join me to try out this map right now, okay? We have a comment in the chat, go Eclipse versus Terran. Okay, I'm going Eclipse and I'm hosting this. You can join, guys, okay? Name is Ray1, password is 1. We are on Europe, okay? I'm on Europe and you can join this right now. One of my clan mates. Okay, he's actually going to the observers. Okay, guys, so Lucky Noob already knows the map. You're free to join. Ah, Tetsuo, okay, you're in the chat actually. Okay, I didn't know. Yeah, Tetsuo, I didn't know that you came from the stream. You can go up if you want and. Okay, so I'm showing you the map now. And this is, as you could see, on 19 different maps. I have all the popular maps for this, okay? So what you can see here, bam. You have every single building from every single race, okay? So the point of this is you want to practice a big battle. So I'm going to write in the chat here. Okay, let's make a 100 supply PVT fight. You get 100 supply Protoss. Just build them at the top left. So he's making one supply Protoss, and I'm now making a Terran army, okay? Let me get some siege tanks, siege, vulture speed, mines. And every unit I build here spawns here, okay? So I can make an army. We look at the supply at the top. I make some Goliaths, I make a vessel maybe, some vultures. Maybe a few more tanks. Okay, we are done. And now, let's fight in middle. Okay, maybe I get 2-1 upgrades. Just a realistic situation, you know? 2-1 upgrades, and here we go. So I'm going to lay mines here, and we are trying to push this Protoss. So this is practicing, this is me practicing Terran army control right now, okay? And I'm noob with this. I'm very noob, okay? I'm very noob here. He's just running into the tanks. This is Terran. Almost, bro. Okay, so this is not the map that you play versus random people on Battle.net and you crush them, okay? This is really for targeted, focused practice. If you really want to improve your game at certain situations in the game, you do this, and you have a friend, you speak about the situation you want to practice with your friend, and then you build it, right? So you talk about the composition as well, and so on, okay? Just normal. Okay, and now after this fight, I will show you more. There's more. So there's way more. So he's making another army. Okay, and now? So let's say I lost this fight, okay? I lost this fight. And now we want to practice the same situation again. That's where this comes into play. You have three buttons here. Player 1 has a configurator and he has three buttons that he can press, okay? These crystals show you what every button does. So here is a button and it kills all the units. So let me just show you. I'm making some units so that you see it. And now I have some units here. And now I use this button, okay? I use this button, kill all units. Bam. Battlefield completely reset. Now you can make your next army, you can practice the same situation. You can analyze your mistakes. You can try to do the same thing and improve your mistakes and be better. You can practice again and again and again. You don't need to waste time to remake the game, to build up another army, to hope for some games in ladder that fits your situation. You can just do whatever you want in a few seconds, okay? So then there's not more. So let's say you have some vessels, okay? These vessels have 50 energy, but let's say you want to have a late game army where you have two vessels at full energy already, okay? There's another button for that. So here is this bottom button. Give all units 100% energy. So here you can see my vessels don't have full energy. And now we just press this button. And bam, we have full energy. And now any other vessel I do still has 50 again, okay? So you can use this button to give all the units that you have existing on the battlefield full energy. So you can make an army with a full energy vessel and a 50 energy vessel, for example. Then you wait a bit and then maybe you have one with 200 and one with 100. Stuff like that. Okay? So he's having fun. I just kill his units. Bam. Dead. Okay. And so the last part is you kill all buildings. You might think, okay, what buildings? What is this gonna accomplish, right? Let's make some probes here. And now we can actually practice a wall in against Zerg. You tell your opponent, please make speedlings. And you make your wall. You practice wall ins on every map. Bam, and here you have your wall in. You make some zealots, you place them in the gaps, and then you're good to go. right? And here you have another beautiful situation that you can practice. Of course, what you see is the buildings get warped in immediately. That's so that you don't waste time. That of course means that you can't simulate situations where you need a certain building to finish and the timing is very important, stuff like that. That is not possible, but you don't waste any time. You can make any natural, you can make a full main base, you can make any situation that you have in a real game. From units, with buildings, whatever, energy, you can all simulate in seconds. And if you have the buildings and you want to reset again, you can kill all buildings here. Of course, this only kills the buildings on the battlefield and not these buildings. Okay? So let's say, just to show you, I make some buildings here now, and now I press this button, kill all buildings, and you can see buildings are killed, units are killed, and you can remake the situation, right? Okay, so that's basically it, and you have, as I said, every ladder map from past season, every clan league map from currently running clan leagues, like I have the BWCL maps from the BWCL season that just finished, and I also have tournament maps. I have the tournament maps from BSL and ASL for you. So you can see 19 maps, those are all the maps, 19 maps here. Every map from future seasons, yes, I will update this map pack for future seasons as well. And now I show you one last thing, okay? I did make a threat here on Team Liquid. I put the link into the chat, and now you can go to this website. This is Team Liquid, obviously. And there's a threat in the forum. You can find it here in the general forum, Race Battle Simulator, here on the left. And this is the threat. I explain everything. You see the screenshots a bit. You see the buttons, I explain how what it is, and now you can download this map pack. You can download it right now and try it out if you want. Here are all the maps again. Here is the download link. You just download this. It's a zip file, and you just extract it to your StarCraft maps folder. So to the maps folder that is inside of your StarCraft installation folder. And that's it. That's it. That easy, you can start this. I'm your first download. I was my own first download. I tested this before I posted it. Yeah, Phil, good today. Of course, this does not cost money. It's literally a StarCraft UMS map. So everyone can use this. Yeah, I'm always open to feedback. Just tell me what you think, what I could improve. With 19 maps, I have to say it's a lot of work to improve like big aspects of the concept. But for example, adding a map, especially adding a map in the next season, or let's say the next BWCL season or BSL season starts and there are new maps released, like 2-3 new maps, I can just add them. It doesn't take a lot of work. Lyrics. I downloaded it. It was charged on my bank account. Oh man. Yeah. So guys, that's it. And now I will actually. Should I do it? Yeah, you know what? Let's do it. Let's go back to the thread here. And you know there is. Thanks. How can I support you somehow? No, I don't want money. yeah, spread the word about this project. Check out my Twitch stream. That's what you're already on. So that's already done. And now, join my new Discord community server. So this is the first time I make this information public. I created a new Discord server that I want to talk about all my streams, about all my projects on. And I would appreciate it if any one of you guys following me here on Twitch checks that server out, and you can always discuss everything that is related to me, to my projects, to my tournament results, to my clan wars on that Discord server. So it would be nice if you join this Discord server. I have to say it's not 100% complete yet. So it will have some additional channels in the next like 2 weeks or so. For example, information about my coaching and so on, and a little section about this one as well. But yeah, you can already join, and once the activity ramps up, you can see what gets added to it in the next few weeks. So just keep it in mind. Please don't join it and think, ah, okay, there's nothing here, or the activity is low, and leave it again. So it's really, I really have bigger plans with that, okay? So it would be nice if you join it and be one of the first people to be on the server. Okay. So many maps as well. I've downloaded it. Okay. Ray, who you think will win, Flash versus Soma? Depends on how often Flash gets Terran. I'm not convinced about his Protoss and Zerg. I mean, we didn't see any of his Zerg so far. It was just like a, what was it, 8 pool or so he did against, or 9 pool against 8 Rex or so. So that you can't really count that. Anyone could win that game. And the Protoss games were pretty gimmicky in my opinion. One game, for example, he made the hidden expansion. One game he basically only won because Snow for some reason made a big army positioning mistake. So I'm not really convinced about his Protoss and Zerg. I am convinced that they will be good at some point, but I'm just not convinced that they are good right now and that they are on the level that Soma's Zerg is. So I think if he can get Terran in like half of the games, I can think he takes it. But if he does not get Terran, I think Soma takes it. That's my prediction there. I really think Soma's a really good player. It is a coin flip, but the coin has three sides, and Flash needs one side to come up more often to win. Larva versus Zero. You mean Larva versus Queen, right? Yeah, should be Queen. Yeah, Queen. Well, it's a ZVZ. Also coin flip. It's all coin flips. StarCraft is just a coin flip game. Like, highest level of play, Korean ASL, all coin flips. Okay, yeah. ZMRDII, Flash is the Flash, he will win or lose. True statement. Not bad. Only one I want to win is Boxer, Nalra, Yellow or Mr. Ray. Well, sadly, three of those players are not playing anymore. But so I guess you know who to root for. Okay, guys, I think we are ready for another game, right? Let's do another 1 hour PvP. Boxer is still playing, but not like not seriously, right? He's not like grinding out the ladder or practice partners 8 hours a day. He's just playing every now and then, right? He's actually grinding out 8 hours every day. Do you have any source for that? Boxer plays League of Legends. Okay, let's see what happens here. We have another game in the matchmaker coming up. He still streams on Afrika, I see. Yeah, but I'm not interested about playing or streaming on Afrika in general. I would be interested if he really streams like 8 hours a day, actively practicing real StarCraft games, not playing around with other people, playing fastest, playing custom games, talking about stuff on a stream. If he really actively plays like 6-8 hours a day, then I take it seriously. But before that, not really. Okay, we got a game. Oh, we don't. Okay. So, back to the chat. Oh, by the way, I have a new bot as well, Streamlabs. The night bot was not good. Now it's Streamlabs bot. It has some commands, let's see. Commands. The available commands are bracket uptime. Set. I think uptime is actually not correct, to be honest. Let's see. Yeah, okay, so uptime is not correct, but the rest is correct. Okay, all the other commands are correct. The bracket is for my last BSL cast. But now we have a game. Sudden Life, I just see that you linked the 2017 ASL. I know that he played in that, but I thought we are talking about right now. I know that he's playing, like that he played after StarCraft 2 for a bit, but that's not relevant to me if he's not really playing a lot. Okay, so what do we have here? Darkness. Oh, another Protoss, okay. Okay, here 2.1k, really? Sudden Life, that was 2017. We have end of 2020. I was asking if he's actively playing right now. Like actively playing a lot of games right now. In this month, in the last month. I don't care about the past. Okay, I guess I have to read it more carefully, but I thought you were talking about Ace L4 in 2017, and that's definitely in the past. And just a game here, and like every now and then, like every week, two games or so, right now, are not interesting to me either. So, did he fast expand or not? That's the question here. Oh, no fast expansion, okay. We have a game. Oh, he lost the probe. That's nice. Probably an expansion as well. Sadly, I'm supply blocked right now, so I can't make the observer.
You have not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals. You not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals.
Initiated. Not that soon.
You have not enough minerals.
Wait, what is he doing? Reaver, but he's in pretty bad position now. Where's my observer? Okay, this is my drop defense. Does he have a hidden expansion or what? What's going on? Wow. Okay, I don't see an hidden expansion. But yeah, he did kill a lot of stuff.
I have returned. Commencing. We are under attack. Kalanos, not time.
Awaiting instructions. Upgrade complete. My life for all.
Oh wow! I still have all the probes! Wow!
You have not enough minerals.
That's nice! I think I'm fine here, right? I have a good probe count. Oh my god. Oh man. Yeah, okay, now it's, I think it's over. Why is this not shooting? Oh my god. This is my only chance. Okay. Ah, well, wrong strategy. Just wrong strategy. I went for a contain at his base. He went for defense into mass drops with speed shuttles. Well, unfortunate. I should scout more, I guess. I should have like observer flying in, checking his army, checking his base and so on. I didn't do that. So, yeah. So I chose the wrong strategy and I lose for it. Probes in my bottom right. Yeah, the second double shuttle drop killed me. Okay, it looks like we got another game. Yes. Oh, CRVT. Isn't this guy almost S rank? Wasn't he like in the Gosu League quarterfinal or semifinal last season? I think he's S. Ah yeah, you confirm it, nice. So why am I always so unlucky? It's always the same. I'm playing against so many S rank players on B rank accounts. Why is this happening? I don't get it. Like, is this intentional? Or am I just incredibly unlucky to meet them, to meet only the S ranks that are having a bad time and have a losing streak or so? Why is this always happening? He's usually high A. Yeah, but now he's like mid B. But I guess you could say that. Yeah, not really for me. I'm usually low A. They're stream sniping you. Nah, I don't think so. It's his main account. Wow.
Enough minerals.
you said to me. Confirmed. I have returned.
You have not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals.
My life for I have not enough minerals.
To construct additional pylons.
Dwarf, I have needed Nagatsu for vengeance. Confirmed. I have returned. Receiving for vengeance. Isatsu! I am needed for vengeance. Mitora.
Damn, now he sees it. Oh god, this is horrible. Oh, this was way too early. Yeah, now I have a problem.
You must construct additional pylons. You must construct additional pylons. You must construct additional pylons. You must construct additional pylons.
Galassos. Zapkalados. Lopai. Galassos. Mitora.
Your warriors have indeed not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals.
My life for I. Galassos. Transmit. Initiated. Galassos. Zapkalados. Make use of me. Confirmed for vengeance. Lopai. Initiating or commencing. Awaiting instructions.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Is he not? He's just pushing with slow reavers now, right? I guess that's it. Yeah, I thought he's going 3 gate, but he was only 2 gating and he went reverse behind that. If you watch a pro stream, you see that they rarely play with black minimap. What do you mean? You mean if you press tab that you don't see the terrain? Yeah, nah, I don't like that. I think it's sometimes important to really position the army in a certain spot on the terrain and you don't see that if it's black. For example, especially in PVT, if a terran comes out in a certain path on the terrain, you want to have your army in a nice concave around that specific choke, for example. The choke is coming out. And to really position your army groups in that exact position, you really need to see the choke, you know? So I don't really like black minimap. Okay, we have another game, another PvP. Only PvPs today. That's why you use tap. I don't know, I don't... Like, okay, so... If you want to discuss a certain aspect of the game, it's not about saying how to fix issues with that specific thing. It's about arguing what does a change of your normal behavior give you for a benefit. So I would love to know what you think is the benefit of that. It's easier to see drops and stuff when it's dark. Okay, so that's the benefit. I think it's totally fine on a terrain minimap. But what I should do is actually switch the colors to green and red. If you see the red dot, if you can really always switch these colors to green and red, then your opponent, all the drops, all the danger is always red. And I think your brain actually gets more used to it, you know? If you have it at the same color every time, every game, only red, then I think you will over time see the red more easily, more of like quickly, right? Yeah, I've personally not seen it for anyone so far. Doesn't matter if Korean or not. I've never seen it before that a good player uses it on stream or so. If you heard some pros using it, you can just check that because they are often streaming. Got it! Not a single probe lost. Mm.
Kronos, I have returned. I am needed. Commencing. Upgrade complete. Commencing. Make use of me. Commencing. Not answered. Commencing.
Ah! Ah, I fucked up my hotkeys.
Additional pylons. You must construct additional pylons. Not enough. You must construct additional pylons. Not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals. You must construct additional pylons. You must construct additional pylons. You must construct additional.
How many pylons do I still need? Holy shit.
You have not enough minerals. Chaos.
My life for ire. You have not enough minerals. What battle claws?
Oh, almost another one! Oh my god! Ah, damn it. He always needed one more pylon. Yeah, okay. Was I think I didn't take a lot of damage against the initial zealot rush, and with that, I think I was in a pretty good spot. Oh, feel good today. There you go. One of our followers here. Is this letter? Yes, it is letter. Jal Makasoyo. What is Jalmaka Soyo? Is it well done? Psystorm you? Okay, we are doing another game here. I'm searching. So let me check our thread here. Do we have some comments already? Nice, this looks amazing, thank you. Time to crush the opposition. Yeah, thank you guys for supporting. I know Lucky Noob, Phil are definitely in the stream right now. Thanks for the feedback, guys. Okay, we got another game, maybe. Who knows? Jan Min. Any luck on the Korean? What do you mean, any luck? I think learning a language probably is not like very luck dependent. Yeah, but it's going well. I'm at 184 days today, so I did learn Korean for 184 days, and yeah, I think I'm progressing fine. I know like 830 words by now, 840 or so, maybe, and yeah, I'm learning a lot of grammar as well. I'm not just learning vocabulary or so, I'm learning a lot of grammar, like mainly grammar. And I can build a lot of different kinds of sentences already. It's good. We have another Protoss, by the way. And it's laggy. It's super laggy. So, Psystorm U. Do you actually know Korean? Because you wrote something in Korean earlier in the chat. Like, a minute ago or so. Jal Makasoyo. Yeah, I understand. Like, don't take every word I say seriously. Sometimes I just mock a bit, you know? Okay, before we take the gas, I actually want to see if he's proxying me. Okay, he's not. Okay, good. Well, he could proxy me outside here. Okay, looks like he's not. Oh wait, he's also going for two zealots. Ah. Ah no, never mind. I don't think he is.
sensing.
Summon Calados.
I have returned.
Calados.
Come on. I am needed.
You require more Vespine gas.
You have not enough minerals.
It's our option.
Pass, I sir.
Calados.
Receiving.
Come on.
Receiving. I have returned.
Initiating.
Loctai.
Sam
Calados.
Galassos.
I am needed.
Loctai.
Mitona.
For vengeance.
Nagatsu.
For vengeance.
Nagatsu.
Complete.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Your
warriors have engaged the enemy.
I am needed.
You have not enough minerals.
I have returned.
Receiving. Awaiting instructions.
Transmit.
You have not enough minerals.
The enemy also.
Transmit.
Confirmed.
I am needed.
I have returned.
You have not enough minerals.
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 Looks good.
Not enough minerals.
Some Calados.
You've not enough minerals.
Loctai.
The warriors have engaged the enemy.
Confirmed.
You've not enough minerals.
You've
not enough minerals.
I have seen it.
Confirm. You have not enough minerals.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Oh. Was nice. Nee. Okay, let me read the screen here and translate. Nee. Tunion. Nee, Tunion. Dung an. Hangukore Beu Goita. I'm learning Korean for 2 years. Nice. Yeah, it's so funny if you're at the stage that you can speak to Koreans and they your Korean is so good that they don't believe that you're not Korean. That's the level I want to reach. You know, if I reach that level, that's it. That's my goal there. Okay, we have. Whoops, another search here. And we got another game. Oh, another matchup. No PvP. Are you hyped, guys? Okay, so the build is, well, the same build that you can see by entering exclamation mark PVZ in the chat. I don't have a second zealot building. Oh, that's a problem.
Honor guide me. For a good
class I serve. Isatu, class I serve. My life for I, honor guide me. I long for combat. Gaokora, for a new woman. She house, but not claws. Isatu. My life for ire. Isatu. I long for combat. But now, claws, you have not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals. She house for a goon. You have not enough minerals. But now, claws, honor guide me. She house, honor guide me. But now, claws, Gaokora, plus I serve. Gaokora, plus I serve. I long for combat. For a goon. Plus I serve. I long for combat. Honor guide me. You must construct additional pylons. You must construct additional pylons. You must construct additional pylons. For a goon. Honor guide me. Plus I serve. You must construct additional pylons.
Oh, this pylon did not build. Oh my god.
Upgrade complete. I long for combat. I serve. I long for combat. Honor guide me.
Oh, really? Am I I'm dying to this? Where's my upgrade? Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm really dying to this. Can't believe I'm dying to this. Sad, very sad. It was so look at this, even in the end I had way more resources, he was so all in. If I just somehow survive, I win the game. Even after not using my my natural for the last 2 minutes and wasting like half of my probes trying to defend, I still have like 1k more resources. That shows you how all in he was, man. Good night, Sun Life, if you're still here. I really didn't think that he will break me after I killed off his first wave of Hydra. I had 2 cannons, I had like 3 more finishing up, but he really had the perfect time in killing those 2 cannons exactly when the other 3 were at like 90%, and then he kills them and it's over. By the way, I think last game for today, then I'm going offline. It's another PvZ. You know what? Let's do this. We're going for a 1-base PvZ. Very horny.
You have not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals.
not enough minerals. You have 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 not enough minerals. You must construct additional pylons. Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Okay, that's it for the probes. Not a single more other probe. Actually, let's cancel this one. Okay, we are ready.
Thank you. have engaged the enemy.
Not enough minerals. You have not enough minerals.
He's probably come with Mutalis soon. But then again, against ranged goons? Maybe not.
Minerals. My life.
have not enough minerals.
I heed thy call.
You have not enough minerals. 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 You have not enough minerals.
My life for iron. My life for iron.
You think as I do. Cassada de Clarion.
my pride.
Yeah, he was way ahead the whole time. After he crushed my first move out, when I lost my first storm army, from that point on the game was basically over. It looked kinda close, I was winning some fights, but it was obvious that behind that he has way more economy, and you can see it here. Okay, well, not the best results again. I'm really not doing well in ladder this season so far. But yeah. You still made it close, in my opinion. Yeah, the fights look close, but I don't think it was close. He had like 5 bases probably, and much overmints and gas and everything, and a lot of production. Even if I kill like 2 armies of him, I still lose the game, I think. I don't think it was close. Just the fights look close because he was not investing everything into army, he was investing a lot in his infrastructure and expansions and so on. That's why the fights itself look close, I think, at least. Yeah, so we actually have 31 viewers again. We had a few less earlier. So I'm just linking this one more time for anyone who didn't see it. Definitely check out this link that is now in the chat. It's this thread here on Team Liquid, Master Race Battle Simulator. It's a, yeah, just read it. Just very short summary. Custom map where you can simulate every single situation that could occur, just any battle. If you want to practice big battles, that's the map for you. You can download it here. It has all the maps that are currently on ladder, last season, or clan wars, tournaments, whatever. 19 maps here. You can basically practice every single situation on all of these maps. That's it. And yeah, that was just for anyone who wasn't here earlier. Yeah, and now I will wrap up the stream and say thanks everyone for watching. Don't forget to follow if you want to see more awesome StarCraft content. And maybe I will do some a little bit better in my ladder games very soon. And don't forget to tune in to BSL on Tuesday on Zero stream. So I did cast the round of 8, match 3 and 4 on Thursday, so yesterday. The semi-finals will be casted by Zero and someone else, I'm not sure who. It's a surprise. That will be on Tuesday, and then on Thursday there's a BSL Ghost League finals. I'm not sure who is casting that, but it could be Zero again. It could also be me, together with my co-caster Snipe on this channel. I'm not sure, but to find out, we all have to tune in to Zero stream on Tuesday to watch the BSL Ghost League semi-final, and then he will probably announce it in the end. Okay, so that's it. Thanks a lot for watching, and bye-bye.